Hi guys, welcome to our channel. Today we have our another guest tutor, Nitin Saurab from Tonsomar. And in this tutorial, he will teach us about how to create a random meme generator using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. He is a very talented web developer. Mostly he creates HTML, CSS, JavaScript tutorials for beginners. He has some amazing projects on his channel. So don't forget to check out his channel for more projects like this. Now let's enjoy the project.
Hello everyone, I am Nitin, also known as Tonsomar, developer of Gulper.io, an online multiplayer video game. If you haven't played it yet, open your browser and enjoy it. And in today's video, we are going to dive into the world of web development and explore how to create a meme generator using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. But before we get started, I just wanted to take a moment to thank Tech2ETC for having me as a guest tutor on their channel. It's a great privilege to share my knowledge and expertise with such a wonderful community of learners. So without further ado, let's jump into today's topic, that is creating a meme generator using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Let's have an overview of this project. Here, you can see the web page, and now we are gonna explore the elements of this page. So here we are having a generate meme button. And when we click on this, it triggers the JavaScript to generate a new meme. Here you can see a new meme is displayed over here. And we are gonna fetch these memes by an API that lets us get memes from different subreddits. And at the bottom, you can see the author's name by whom the meme is created. Hope you understood this project. So now grab your favorite code editor and let's get coding. So right here, I have created this folder called meme generator and I have just opened this with VS Code. So let's go ahead and start by creating the necessary files. So let's create a new file and let's name it as index.html. And let's create another file and I will name it as style.css. And let's also create a main.js file. Alright, let's start with the HTML file. So in VS Code, you have a shortcut where you can just press exclamation and press tab and you will have this basic HTML5 code. So right now, let's link our CSS file over here. So I will just type link and press tab. And here I will just type style.css. And I will also link the JavaScript file over here. So I will just type script:src and press tab. And in the src, I will type main.js. So now let's start by creating a division to contain everything. So let's give it a class of meme generator. And in that, the first thing we will do is to create a button. And we will give it the class of generate meme button. And here we will have a text of generate meme. And after that, we will have a title of the meme. So let's create an h2 and we will give it the class of meme title. And we will add a loading text here. Now let's create an image tag for the meme. So in the src, we will get the link of the generated meme. And then lastly, we will have a division of the class of meme author. So that's basically with the HTML. Let's go to our CSS and let's start styling this. So before that, let's open this in our browser. So I have this extension called Live Server installed in VS Code. So once we install this, you can just right click over here and click on Open with Live Server. Now let's go to style.css file and first of all, let's target the meme generator division. This division right here. So let's type .memeGenerator and we will set the font family to Roboto and Sans Serif. And we will also text align everything to center. Right now, let's add a default height to the meme image. So let's type meme generator image and we will give it a height of 430 pixels. And I will also set object fit to cover so that it has a correct aspect ratio. So now let's style the button. So let's type meme generator and for the button we have a class of generate meme button. So let's type generate meme btn And let's add a padding of 8 pixels top and bottom and 20 pixels left and right. So let's set the border to none and we will add some border to left and the right. So let's type border left and let's set it to 4 pixels solid dark gray. And also for the border right, we will type 4 pixels solid dark gray. And we will also set a margin of 24 pixels top and bottom and 0 for left and right. And let's set the font size to 20 pixels and let's set the color of the text to F6 4D. And let's set the background color to white. And we will also set the cursor to pointer. So when you hover this, we need to have the pointer. So let's type cursor pointer. Right now, let's add a hover effect. So here I will just type meme generator, generate meme button, clone, hover. And when we hover this, we will have a padding of 8 pixels top and bottom. And for left and right, we will have a padding of 36 pixels. And we will also set the border left to 8 pixels, solid dark gray. And let's just duplicate this. And here I will just type border right. And we will also add letter spacing. So let's type letter spacing of 3 pixels. And here we will also add a transition so that we will have a smooth animation. So let's type transition of all to 400 milliseconds ease. And now we have this hover effect for the button. So now for the meme author, we will just add a little bit of margin. So let's type meme generator dot meme author and let's add a margin of 8 pixels. And that's it for CSS and styling. Now let's go to our main.js file and let's add the JavaScript. Now first of all, let me show you the API that we are gonna use for the meme generator. Now this is the GitHub page for the meme generator API. So if we scroll down, we can see that we have some instructions on how to use this. So this is the link of the API. So if we just go to this link, we will get a random meme. And this is the response that we will get. So we will get the post link and then we will get the subreddit from which the meme is generated. And then we will get the title and URL and all those things over here. And you can also get these preview images. And if you scroll down, we can see that we can also specify how many memes you want to have. And below this, we can also specify the subreddit. I mean, if you know the name of the subreddit that you want to get the memes from, then you can just add that after this link. So here we can see we are getting plenty of memes from this API. Alright, so now let's go back to our JavaScript file and first of all, let's reference some of the elements from the HTML. So we need to reference the generate meme button, we need to reference the meme title and the meme image and also the meme author. So let's reference all of these. So let's type const generate meme button equals document.querySelector. And then let's type meme generator.generate meme button. Then we have the meme image. So let's type const meme image equals document.querySelector meme generator img. And then we have the meme title. So let's type const meme title equals document.querySelector meme generator meme title. And then lastly we have the meme author. So let's type const meme author equals document.querySelector meme generator meme author. Right now let's add an image listener to this generate meme button. So let's type generate meme button dot add event listener and let's listen for the click event. And when we click on the generate meme button, we will call a function called generate meme. So let's type generate meme and we will create that function right now. So let's type const generate meme And here we will use the fetch API to get the response from the API. So let's type fetch, and here we will add the link of the API. So let's go back to our GitHub page and let's copy this link from here and let's paste it over here. You can add the name of any subreddit you want here over here. Now after that, let's type dot then, and here we will get the response in JSON format. So let's type response. You can name this anything you want, and we will create an error function. And let's type response.json, and after that we will have one more than, and here we will extract the data from this response. So I will just name it data, and let's create an error function, and here I will just call a function called update details. And we will create that function in a minute. So let's type update details. And in this, we need to pass some value. So we will pass the URL of the image. So let's type data, which is the data that we get over here, and dot URL. So if you go back to the GitHub page, we can see that we are getting this URL. So you have to add the same keyword. So here we have URL. That's why we have this data.url. And we also need to get the title. So let's type data.title. Here we can see for the title, we have this title. And then we need to have the author. So for the author, we have this keyword author. So let's type data.author. And let me just arrange this. So here we have that then, and we have this response, and then we will have this then over here. Right now, let's create this function called updateDetails. So let's type const updateDetails. And here we will just have this meanImage.set attribute. Now, here you have to set the src attribute. So if we go back to the index.html file, here we can see we have this image tag, and in that we have the src attribute. So let's type src, and here in this function we also need to get all these parameters. So for the URL, I will just give it a name of URL, and for the title, I will just give it a name of title. And then we have the author. So right here in the src, I will just type URL, and then we will type meme title dot inner html equals title, and meme author dot inner html equals author. And here I will just have a typo, so we have to type URL. Right now, let's go back to our website. And let's click on this generate meme button. So here we can see we have this meme, and we have the title, we have the image, and also the author's name displayed over here. Now for the author, we also have to type meme by. So let's go back to our JavaScript, and here for the author, I will just add it inside a backtick, and here I will just type meme by. And here I will just add dollar symbol and curly braces for this variable. Now the last thing we will do is we will generate this meme when the page loads. So let's go back to our JavaScript. And here, I will just call this function called generateMeme. So, I will just type generateMeme. And now, let's go back to our website. So, here we can see we have this meme generated when the page loads. And if I click on this generateMeme button, we have this new meme generated over here. And that's it for this video. You can get the source code of this project and the API link from the description below. So thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.